So I went to art middle school and then I went to a STEM high school. I really liked the environment of that STEM-based high school. And so MIT has always been a first choice.
One of the criteria that my parents put was you have to get a scholarship. And MIT covered the need-based financial aid. Honestly, having that scholarship helps alleviate a lot of the stress and gives me a lot of resources to make my own path.
Trying to figure out what I wanted to do was a huge part of
my education.
Maybe I should try architecture. And so I tried it and I was like, okay, I like this.
So the project that we're looking at has a site near the Charles.
We're taking that site to
develop a residential space, a productive space, and also like an ecological point of view.
The project really gives me a lot of flexibility.
Right now I'm exploring this childhood outlook of multiple perspectives to create a new sense of discovery, connecting these spaces and creating an artist residency space.
I did a lot of stuff in the arts field.
That kind of thing helps you think in architecture about design and creativity.
Dance helps me think spatially. My mom introduced me to Chinese traditional dance. It gives me a nice creative outlet, and then it also allows me to connect more with my cultural side. My dad's actually from rural China, and he does soil qualities. Growing up in Florida,
you become very interested in plants, landscapes, and sustainability measurements. For architecture, if I explore more landscaping, because I really like that nature part, I think it's very helpful. And I think that's why I joined the Garden Club, to explore more of the seasonal changes, because Boston's very different. With MIT's financial support, I don't have to worry about a lot of the things that I probably would have to.
I'm able to really figure out what I'm interested in and be able to take those risks.